This mug is great, except I can't drink out of it right now, so I need to make a cavity in here so that I can drink out of it. Now, we used for the body, if you remember, a cylinder, all right? Now, the real question to ask is, what shape is the hole made out of? Now, in Tinkercad, you need to think of holes as if they are 3D objects or 3D bodies of air. So, if I'm going to make a hole in here, which is the same as a cylinder, I'm going to use a cylinder, but instead of a solid cylinder, I'll use a cylinder of air. Now, they are the box and the cylinder that's already made in this way, but I'll show you how to actually add any shape and turn it into a hole shape. Okay, so let's drag the cylinder that we want to use first down here, and let's make it the approximate size of what we're looking for. Okay, so I'm gonna make it taller, I'm gonna make it bigger. Okay, and you want to make sure that the hole for the cup is slightly taller than the cup itself or the mug itself, so that when I drag it in the mug, I don't lose it in the mug, right? There you go. So now I'm going to adjust these sizes. Remember, if you hold down shift while dragging these squares at the bottom here, you will scale everything equally. And then I'm just kind of, guessing where the center is for now. So you can look at the top view is the easiest way to do this. And then boom. Okay. I'm going to make it a little shorter. All right. So now, if we grouped this the same way we did with the handle right now, we would just have this solid body in the solid body. So what we want to do is make this larger, well, I guess taller cylinder a hole shape first. So we're going to click on hole over here. And now you'll see that this shape is just kind of a cylinder of air. But we're not done yet. If we group this right now, what's the problem that some of you might see? Well, the object is touching the ground. So if we group it right now, our mug will have a hole in the bottom and you won't be able to fill it with any liquid. So we need to do what we did for the handle. We need to slightly bring this up just a tad using the black arrow right here. We're just gonna lift it off the ground, okay? And we can see that it's lifted off the ground. Now I can repeat the step as from the video before, which is just selecting everything and grouping. Okay, and you can see the hole was cut.